Hi, welcome back, and welcome to the Azure SQL Scenario Challenge number one. Now, we're trying something interesting, and what we're going to do is we're going to provide you a challenge, and then we're also going to give you a hashtag, and we encourage you to participate on Twitter, on LinkedIn, or in the comments for this video, and let us know what you think the answer to the challenge should be, or what a potential solution might be. And now, to make this really interesting, I thought maybe we'd challenge Bob. Now, Bob didn't know until just now that he's going to be included in this challenge, and he has not seen the scenarios. So part of the challenge will be trying to figure out, you know, can you beat Bob, or can you come up with a better idea than Bob, or, you know, that sort of thing, because it's Bob Ward. So, Bob, do you think you're up for the challenge?
Well, I guess. I mean, if you're going to put me on the spot like that in a live stream video, sure, I'm up for the challenge.
All right. Well, let's take a look at the first scenario. So, Bob, you might want to read this so you can kind of figure out a solution on the fly. But basically, this is a scenario around a global CDN system or a content delivery network system. And they're trying to get content around the world, and they need some help. And they have some requirements, which you can see in here. So, Bob, what do you got?
Oh, okay. So I'm obviously not a speed reader, but I see the word SQL a lot. That's good. I see the word Azure a lot.
How about I give you some hints?
Yeah. It would be nice to have some hints. Yeah, I would love that. Thank you. Especially since I'm challenging the world here. How are you going to give me hints?
Yeah. All right. So here's some hints. I went ahead and I highlighted some things that I think might be, you know, more important to think about. So,
So now
maybe that helps give you some ideas.
Okay. So across the globe, and we've talked about in Azure with our series about how many regional solutions we have, right? So I'm going to want to pick something where we can replicate across the globe. I think, and I'm looking at scale where users live, right? So, So in order to do that, I think I'm going to need, you know, I don't know. I mean, maybe some sort of geo, you know, replication solution that we've talked about. That's one thing I just kind of see right here. Thousands of writes per second. So I remember when we did our tiers, we had different IO requirements, latencies and IOPS. So to get the maximum IO that I need. I see CLR here. Oh, okay. So that's probably SQL CLR. So I got to go right to managed instance because I don't have that for Azure Database. So I know that. Okay. I'm going to do managed instance. I'm going to probably go maybe. I'll tell you what. I'm probably going to go with business critical managed instance, business critical deployment managed instance. I don't know how many cores I need though. I'd have to go look and see maybe, you know, does a certain core level give me a certain amount of IO? And if I remember correctly, the number of files and the size of files can affect IO performance in a managed instance. I do remember that. That was when we talked about in performance.
Yep.
So I'll have to consider that with 1,000 writes. To go across the globe and scale, I think I want to get some replicas. Now, business critical gives me a read replica, but I want more probably. So maybe I'll do like a failover group. I know that's supported with MI. That can give me some read scale. So I'm kind of thinking up there up top. That's maybe what I'll do. Authentication. So I'm looking at this authentication thing. Okay, it's interesting. So I've got a non-Azure machine with an app and a legacy app on a non-Azure machine, which means they're on premises. So, you know, I've got to network this thing together as we've talked about, but I already have that with managed instance. I can do virtual networks with my apps. Now, for the legacy app, I'm guessing they can't change the connection. Okay, probably it's SQL auth. They're probably using like a SQL authentication. And if I can't change the connection string, I don't have a choice. So I'm going to have to use, you know, my virtual network, but I may have to take a look at firewall. I'm not sure about that one now. But for the app that's on the non-Azure machine, it doesn't say legacy. And it says down here, I don't want to hard code passwords, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm thinking Azure Active Directory. We talked about that a lot during security, how to go set that up. I'll probably want an Azure AD admin. And SSMS, which is that SQL tool, allows me to do that. I remember an SSMS or even ADS. I can do Azure Active Directory, so I'll have my admins use that from their on-premises environment with a virtual network, and that app that's listed, because there's two apps talked about, maybe I can actually change it to do Azure AD, but this legacy app probably has to stay with SQL auth. So I don't know, that's kind of what I would do. Probably somebody else has some more detailed ideas, but what are you thinking? Is that Not bad.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I got to say, Bob, I don't know why I'm surprised, but I'm pretty impressed with what you came up with. I think there are
This is the first I've really seen this. I'm like, but you didn't give me these hints. It would have taken me longer to kind of go through probably the terms, so.
Yeah, well, you know, I appreciate, you know, your good spirit and attempt here. And, you know, there's a hashtag up on the screen. It's hashtag Azure SQL Global One. So if you want to compete with Bob or give feedback on what Bob said, or even suggest your own solution, because I think there are a few things Bob might have missed. Granted, he just looked at this for the first time, so it might be understandable.
And I would love to see somebody draw this out. Like, I would love to see somebody challenge us by putting a diagram together that kind of connects all the pieces. That would be my utopia. I'd love to see that.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, we would love to see it. You know, you can add the hashtag, you can tag us on Twitter, you can comment in this video. We really want this to be fun, and I want to see who can beat Bob Ward. So thanks for joining us, and see you in the next challenge.